Hi, I'm Patricia Durgan, founder of ProfitFromYourMessage.com. Today I'm at the Greater Philadelphia Christian Writers Conference in Pennsylvania, speaking with one of the lovely faculty members who's very accomplished, very well-known author, speaks internationally, a faculty member, quite a broad spectrum of offerings that she has. This is Karen Whiting. Hello, thanks very much for taking the time to speak with me.
Thanks for having me here, Patricia. I always enjoy seeing you.
Oh, my new best friend. Let's talk about, we're going to get to your conference, what you're teaching here, your books, your website, your international speaking, but let's start with your books.
Well, we could start with My Princess Devotions, the 1 year My Princess Devotions, which is just a wonderful book for girls, but the reason I did this one is I really wanted children, little girls, to realize they're not just wearing the princess and outside looking like one. They're part of God's kingdom. Mm-hmm. And as that, to belong to Him, just like belonging to a family, you can participate and become a princess in action. So every day there's a little action for the girl to do.
Now, what else do you have here for us?
Well, we're going to mention one thing, that this one just received a big award.
Oh, yes.
The Christian Retailers chose this for the Christian Retailer 2014 Best Award Children's Nonfiction. And that's chosen by the book that the retailers think has the most impact on the life of the reader of that category.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So few people have the opportunity to win such an award.
Yeah.
It must have been very special to you.
It sort of blew me away. I can't tell you the competition that was up against. So you can go online and see who the finalists were, and they were such big names, so well known. I never expected to actually win this. I thought, what an honor to be a finalist. And then to get it, I was like, oh, wait, that's me. Surprise.
And then you also have another book you were going to show us.
Yes, Nature Girl, A Guide to Caring for God's Creation. This one is my newest book, and I did it with my daughter. My Ooh. Oldest daughter wrote it with me. How much fun is that?
Yes.
And it is full. It's for the older girls, ages 9 to 14, and it is full of crafts, activities, games, ways to make our earth better and care for it, caring for critters, the water, the air, caring for yourself as a creation of God with a spa party.
Oh, a spa party. I'm interested in a spa party.
With natural recipes for ingredients you make to care for your skin and things.
Now you have one more that's just beautiful. Tell us about that one, please.
Yes, well, this one, actually, when I came here to this conference, Rick Steele, the editor from AMG, and I had done two books with him. We had chatted at a different time that maybe I could do something on the home front. I had the proposal ready when I came here. I had asked someone, Jocelyn Green, to co-author with me because I knew they'd probably only give me 9 months. This is a big book. This covers history from 1755 until now. And because it is stories of faith and courage from the home front, from the French and Indian War to the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Good heavens!
Yes,
I didn't realize it was so broad.
So it was like, and it's chronological, so how can I cover all that research and find original research, you know, letters, journals, newspaper accounts and all from those times, the historic societies I had to visit and all. So I had the proposal ready. Rick looked at this and he was so impressed. He said, this is the best proposal I've seen this year. And he goes, no, this is the best proposal I've seen. Which was so nice. And within weeks of being here, he contracted the book.
Mm. And that was at this specific conference.
This specific conference, yes.
Mm.
And this has since won the Military Writers Society of America Gold Medal.
Good heavens.
For the faith category.
How wonderful that you are. So your work is acknowledged.
Yes.
By people who may or may not fit that target
right.
market, but they can
yes.
see how it serves that yes. target market.
Yes. And of course, you know, they have a series of books. Not just the home front, but they've got a whole Battlefield and Blessings, which is normally about the wars and what uh-huh. happened there. Uh-huh. But I was a military wife. My dad served in World War II. I had an active duty Air Force son,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
a son-in-law who had been in the Army. So for me, I didn't experience going. I experienced being the wife, the mom, the family at home.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why those stories hit my heart, and I wanted to do that.
Mm-hmm. Now tell us about your website. Where can we find these books?
My website is karenwhiting.com, whiting like the fish, W-H-I-T-I-N-G, so K-A-R-E-N-W-H-I-T-I-N-G.com.
Now, there will be links to the resources that we talk about, direct links below this video, so you don't miss anything. Now, going back to the conference you teach, you're a regular teacher, a regular faculty
yes.
member at Marlene's conferences and probably others as well. What are you teaching this year?
This year I did not teach workshops. I was on panels talking about book editors and marketing. I was meeting with people individually to really, I'm really good at brainstorming. I just have
yes,
to get from
are.
The Holy Spirit
yes.
to brainstorm with people on ideas to how to market their book, how to put their book together when it's still kind of loosely in their mind and they're in the formational stage mm-hmm. of that book. And so I did a lot of these special appointments with people.
I've seen you do that, and it's uncanny. Of course, again, it's Holy Spirit driven, but
yes.
they don't have to fit a specific genre. They can
no.
almost toss out whatever their idea is, and you start
right.
having multiple marketing ideas.
I do. It's just something from the Lord that it's a gift that the Holy Spirit's given me to give someone else. It's individual for them,
mm-hmm.
and it's really to help drive their marketing and how, because God gives us all messages in our hearts
yes.
to go to the world, and we as a Christian community should be helping one another to help take those messages.
Yes. Yes.
When you talk about a book to someone else, you are giving legs to that message that God has given someone else.
I like that phrase. I like that phrase. And you have another phrase that's so dear to you.
I always say that I am growing tomorrow's families today. Now, that's, yes, I do write for children, so I am growing tomorrow's families by giving the skills and the faith development for those children of tomorrow, but I'm also growing the families today who say they're dysfunctional. And I will say, I was raised in a functional family. I raised a functional family, and I want to help you start having a functional family tomorrow. And today you can begin that journey of tomorrow.
I'm intrigued by that phrase.
Right.
What's the first step I should take? Do I need to purchase one of your books? Do I need to go to your website?
You can go to the website. I think if you're purchasing a book, one of the first ones is the time book, which is a little bitty time book that I have. It's only 64 pages, fits in your purse or your day planner for the guys. And that one, because before we can start doing things, everybody's who's frazzled saying, how can I do it? Let's get our time under control.
Mm-hmm.
Then I can start my faith walk. Then I have a little bitty book on the home, which is really on relationships, conflict resolution, and other things that will help focus you on how am I going to start my walk and work with my home to get the relationships functional.
Mm-hmm.
How do I nurture my children?
Good.
How do I work with my husband as a partnership?
Mm-hmm.
All of these types of things that are in that book. So I think those are two good starts.
Okay. And the names of them again are?
Well, it's The Secrets of Success for Women, Time and the Home.
What would you suggest to people who are considering going to a big writers conference for the first time? How would you encourage them?
I would encourage them to first look and view, this is an investment for what God has called me to do. If it's a calling, I should be willing to invest time and money into that. And if I don't think I have the resources, I would be creative.
Yes.
I would go to my church and see, would they sponsor me? Can I swap and trade by helping them with their church bulletin mm-hmm. for them to send me to become a
yes.
better writer
yes.
for them?
Yes.
I would go to the business people from my church who travel miles all the time and say, do you have miles that you would donate and get a ticket for me to fly there if I mm-hmm. can't drive and
mm-hmm.
if I can't get there any other way? Be creative to get there, because if God wants you to, He'll help bring along partners and help them realize they're going to be part of your message and your ministry for doing that for you.
Yes. And everybody wins, don't they?
Yes.
In the cycle.
Mm-hmm.
And it all represents God. It all yes. glorifies Him.
Yes.
And it brings His message full circle. Until you come, you can't get your message out. This is an opportunity to refine it, to see if it's going to be able to live. Does it need to change? Do you need to drop that one and start something else that you hadn't even contemplated until you spoke to someone like Karen, who
right.
has more experience, more knowledge, creativity. They've been in the business a long time. They know how it works. They can, which is a real plus.
Yes,
it
is.
There are aspects.
It helped me when I started.
And the faculty here at the Greater Philadelphia Christian Writers Conference and also Marlene's Colorado Conference, you can find out more information about both of those at writehisanswer.com, and that link will also be below the video. The people that she chooses as faculty members are knowledgeable, they're professional, but they're also approachable.
Yes, yes.
You found that to be the case before you were a faculty member?
Right, before I was published and came to conferences. And even as I have been, they're still approachable for me to talk to. And I like to be approachable for conferees and tell them to come. You know, God has gifted me with something that I want to share with you.
Beautiful.
Say, go to that website. Just don't go and sign up. Look through it. Marlene has tons of resources.
Yes.
She tells you who's going to come to the next conference. Check all of those links in their websites to see who will be there, to know what they publish, what they do, what they need.
Yes.
So that you're prepared when you come.
As much as you can be.
Yes, as much as you can be.
And you also speak internationally. Tell us about that place.
Yes. Oh, I've spoken in Malaysia and Russia. That's been a lot of fun. I just really always wanted to go to the Orient, so what an honor to have been asked to go and speak at a creative ministry conference in Malaysia.
Ooh.
And in Russia to be asked to speak, because I was writing for Focus on the Family at the time, they wanted someone who was family-oriented to come. They had a one-week camp where they would train their lay leaders from all over the country that came there to go back and minister to their families.
Train the trainer.
Yes.
In business, it's called
yes.
Train the trainer.
Uh-huh.
And you still speak locally and, regionally, nationally, as well as internationally, if someone's interested?
Well, I'm always open to doing more international.
Always open to international.
And I speak, I'll be out in Tennessee in September, and I was just in Atlanta speaking, and so.
Well, runs the gamut.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Thank you so much for spending some time with me and showing us your books. This is the caliber of people that are coming to the faculty. They're a regular member. There are people who come new, and they only maybe are a faculty member 1 year or 3 years, but there are others that consistently, this is part of their message as well.
Right.
Part of their ministry as well. They see it that way. They treat it that way. I hope you consider coming to one of Marlene's conferences. Again, that's writehisanswer.com. The links will be below. Thanks for joining us.